I haven't been recording. That's not good at all. Well, I got the Venegroth device. And I sailed. Now I'm at Celadon. I'm just gonna complete the game without Virgil. It's fine. Virgil shouldn't have left. Oh, what? Why'd I go here? Thank you.
Are you prepared to face Aranax? Then it is time. May your gods accompany you to the other side and help you to stop Aranax.
Now we're in the void. Yet another death. Where did I sleep?
Are you prepared, then? That's how we do that. Save.
Yes? What is it?
Your presumption is correct. And who might I have the pleasure of addressing? Well, what brings you to my corner of oblivion? That is a feeling I have much familiarity with. Sometimes I feel that my fate was decreed from an early age. Do not misunderstand me. I take full responsibility for my actions. Though, how are one's actions determined, really? How is our view of the world shaped? Mine was shaped by arguably the most powerful individual in the world, my father. He raised me on tales of the righteous superiority of the elves and the destiny that brought us to rule over all the races. What did he expect? He shoved a young, immature, inexperienced fool into a position of immense power and set me loose on the world. Why didn't he stop me? He should have stopped me.
Wait, are you trying to tell me that you feel guilt over what you did?
Most certainly. I have had 2,000 years of my grievous errors and judgment replaying themselves in my mind. One tends to grow a bit of a conscience in all that time.
Where is your new conscience when you threaten my life?
I did no such thing. I've been here for ages. Do you really think I could reach across the void to torment you?
I tire of your lies. Come out of your cell and fight.
You fool! You think this is my protection? This is my prison! I've been trapped inside this shell for nearly 2,000 years!
What? That's impossible. This must be some sort of trick.
I assure you, it is not a light-hearted jest, though I wish that it were. I have been trapped here since soon after I was banished to this realm.
So, who could have possibly trapped someone of your power here?
This is Kerghan's doing. When I first came here and realized what he was becoming, I attempted to stop him. Our battle was intense, yet brief. As you can see, I was not the victor.
He put you here. He was the one I needed to talk to. Good day.
You have more you wish to speak to me about? Your presumption is correct. Well, what brings you to my corner of oblivion? That is a feeling. Do not want it most. I assure you, it is not. This is Kerghan's doing. One and the same. Being that I am trapped in here, my opportunities to get information are, shall we say, a bit limited. On the rare occasion Kerghan has deigned to visit me to play his intellectual games, he has dropped some veiled clues that might make sense in light of what you've told me. If it sounds, that would appear to be the case. If you were able to facilitate my release from this prison, it would be my pleasure to help you destroy Kerghan.
Of course I'll help you. How do I get you out of here?
I'm afraid I do not know. I do not believe Kerghan could maintain this from a distance, so there must be something near here.
I'll be on my way then. See. Closer, move closer.
Ah!
it. There we go, we got...
Many thanks for releasing me from my horribly lengthy incarceration, madam. I am at your service. We could do well to recruit some help. I know some beings in this realm that we might be able to convince to follow us. Perhaps you have heard of them. The Bane of Kree, Gorgoth, and Krakatur. We can only hope. We will have to convince them that Kerghan is a danger to them as well. I don't know. We will need to find a way to navigate amongst the different land masses of the Void using the ancient portals.
Fighting back. box to proceed. Yeah, this is a good party to go into this area with. Definitely is it. Oh, I made it.
I waited for your arrival.
I made it.
Finally, this moment has come. I am Kerghan, first of the necromancers, voyager in the lands of the dead.
I see. Not exactly the person I originally expected.
I would think not. Although the presence of Aranax tells me you already know much of my tale. At least as much as he deemed necessary in order to bring you into his confidence.
Let's see. I've heard his side of the story. Tell me yours.
My life in the world you call Arcanum seems so very distant. The memories clouded like those of a child, and a child I was then, probing the darker magics, given glimpses of the truths yet to come.
The council, were they right about the magics? Look at you.
Yes, look at me. And what do you see? A monster? An abomination? You've no idea what I've discovered. You see with eyes tainted by life, and all what that accursed state embodies. My vision is clear because of those magics you hold in disdain. And the council, it is they I have to thank.
But they punished you. Why would you thank them?
In your world, your Arcanum, I was powerful. Perhaps the most powerful human magicka who has ever been. But to humans, cursed with our shortness of life, our brevity, what is this power? What can be learned in that impermanent spark that is our lives? Nothing. In this so-called prison, there are no limits. There is no end.
I don't understand.
This place, this void, has no time as you know it. I've been here for more than 2,000 of your years, and yet I've aged not at all. I feel as I did the moment they sent me here, or as when the Dark Elves first called to me. Do you now see? Here, I can do everything I did in your world, but I am unfettered by the chains of mortality that time hangs upon us.
But the Dark Elves thought they were calling to Aranox.
Yes, I know. Ironic, isn't it? It was on my ears that their feeble and pathetic cries had fallen. To me, Kerghan, who had defeated their master and thrown him in chains. Kerghan, who had manipulated them into subverting the Benari and weakening the wards. Kerghan, who used them to send me the dwarves of the Black Mountain Clan, who have now finished the bridge back to Arcanum.
Why? If you like it here so much, then leave us alone.
I truly wish I could. My reasons for returning aren't what you'd think. I had no aspirations for power or domination like your companion Aranax did. Aspirations that I became the victim of. No. Those are the motivations of the living, and I no longer place myself among them.
Then what? What is it you want?
If only I could show you the places I've seen, you might understand the things I say. I've been to the desolate lands, wandered by those souls who still see the lands of the living, but wear the cloak of the dead. Blind to their own ends, they cry, passing through one another like shadows in the dying light of day. I've traveled to where souls rot in torment, pierced with the jagged shards of life and vision, clinging to memory, regrets of the flesh. I saw that this prison was of their own making, and the key was in unknowing, in release. And still, I traveled on. And finally, I came to the place where souls go to die, where the mirrored and worn spirits fall into an endless sea of gray, mirrored glass. And I lowered myself within, and lay there among them, and I almost did not return. And do you know what I found there? There, among the silent and battered shells of the innumerable? Peace, enlightenment, truth. Only then did I realize that this place, this life, is an abomination, a horrible distortion of the natural order. this life, who mothered pain and fear and envy, these twisted children who exist only because we are here to feed them, to nourish them. This life, this afterthought, a disturbance, a mere ripple in that great dead sea, not even the cause, but merely an effect, sending these souls upward, screaming for release from the day they are torn from their waters. The effect of what? I do not know, nor do I care. Have you ever spoken with the dead? Call to them from this side? Pull them from their silent rest? Do you know what it is that they feel? Pain. Pain when torn into this wakefulness. This reminder of the chaos from which they had escaped. Pain at having to live. There will be no more pain. There will be no more chaos. I see your soul, traveler. It screams, tattered and spent. Do you feel its pull? Do you hear its wailing? It is within my power to calm these waters, and that is what I shall do.
What do you mean, calm these waters?
I can no longer tolerate the atrocities that this thing, this life, has brought about. There will be peace. There will be quiet. Life will no longer be. And so I go to our kingdom to be an end to it. And then I will join the souls of the dead when it is done.
Perhaps I could persuade you otherwise. You may be wrong.
Am I? It all depends on your point of view. Take yourself, for example. You've been told from the beginning of your adventure that you're the second coming of Nasruddin, the return of the living one. Do you believe it?
Perhaps I'm not one to discount anything, but I'd be inclined to say no.
As well you should. There are no prophecies. It's just the nature of living things to want to conform their existence to a foreseeable pattern, to attempt to exert control over the chaos that surrounds them. Life, by its very nature, disallows this. Life is an accident, the result of random chance. Therefore, its nature can be no different.
That's your opinion. Can you support it?
There are those who would look at all that has happened to you, and then look at you, and call you a madman for not believing in the prophecy. Your opinion is based on what you have seen, what you know. My perceptions on the nature of life and death are no different.
Might I ask you a few questions?
Of course.
Tell me of the Dark Elves and the Black Mountain Clan.
The Dark Elves began calling across the void soon after Aranax had been banished. By the time their feeble cries were heard, their master was already defeated and imprisoned. Pretending I was he, I masterminded the manipulation of the Panari, coerced the Dark Elves into betraying the trusts of Logair and the Wheel Clan, and had the Black Mountain Clan sent to me.
And what has the Black Mountain Clan been doing?
The Black Mountain Clan was brought here because of the nature of technology and magic. The wards which bind the gate back to Arcanum are weakening because of the rise of technology. I brought the dwarves here to construct a device to shatter the wards once and for all. Of course. I want the end to all life. I've divided. Of course. are those who would look at all that has happened to you, and then look at you, and call you a madman for not believing in the prophecy. Your opinion is based on what you have seen, what you know. My perceptions on the nature of life and death are no different.
Perhaps, but my opinion doesn't threaten the whole of creation.
That only bothers you because you see your creation as the natural order of things. I've told you it's only the effect of a meddler, the incoherent scribblings of a child. It's not meant to be.
I suppose it's possible you're correct.
And why not? I realize that you follow the way of the righteous, or at least that's the role you've decided to play. But you've yet to see the other side. Follow me, and I'll show you things you've never imagined.
Your offer is tempting, perhaps.
Are you daft, woman? Are you not listening to what this madman is proposing? He will kill every living being in both realms, including you. I think you have taken leave of your senses. I will allow you this attempt at a peaceful resolution, even though I doubt it has much hope of success.
See. Now, Kerghan, I have a few words to say about this.
Splendid. I've spent the last 2,000 years developing my philosophy, but I'm always eager to hear another's thoughts. Please, proceed.
Very well. Let's speak of the nature of life and death.
Yes, let us speak of this. It is my opinion that the nature of life is accidental. That this reality we experience is merely a distortion of death. What say you, traveler?
As you've said, I have only my experience to draw from.
Yes. But what has that experience taught you? I know not the roads you've traveled, but I do know that all living things feel pain and loss. It's my opinion that they feel these things because they were never meant for what we know as life. Their souls are not equipped for it.
Hold, Kerghan. That assumption is based on your experience.
Yes, you're correct. I concede you that point, but I have seen both sides, whereas you have only the lands of the living. Trust me when I say that the souls who are called back to this life are in the most excruciating pain. It's unnatural.
Maybe your opinions bias your observations.
Are you saying that I can't trust the sight of my own eyes? You presume too much, traveler. You've no idea the things endured by all the souls of the dead because of the thoughtlessness of the living.
Yes, but perhaps that is the nature of those particular souls.
What do you mean? Are you faulting the souls of the dead for the meddlings of the living?
No, but it's fate that some will suffer and some will rest in peace.
I'm afraid that I don't agree with you. And even if I did, Your observation about the randomness of fate or of life only proves my earlier point. The nature of life is chaos because of its unnatural existence. It just should not be here.
I think souls are in pain because they hold on too tightly.
No, I've heard enough. You must choose. Either you see the truth of my words or you do not. Tell me on which side you choose. Life or death.
Alright, this didn't go as planned. Should have looked up a guide of how to persuade him.
I shall send you to that great dead sea, and then you shall know.
It seems we've underestimated our opponents. I am dying. What may I do for you? What would you like for me to do? I think we should be attacking Kerghan. What may I do for you? What would you like for me to do? Is there anything else?
Come on.
Greetings. Long? I would think not. Although the presence of Aranax tells me you already know much of my life. Yeah. This place, this void. Yes, I truly. If only I could show you the places I've seen, you might understand the things I say. I've been to the desolate lands, wandered by those souls who still see the lands of the living, but wear the cloak of the dead. Blind to their own heads, they cry, passing through one another like shadows in the dying light of day. I've traveled to where souls rot in torment, pierced with the jagged. I see your soul, traveler. It screams, tattered and spent. Do you feel its pull? I can no longer tolerate the atrocities that this thing, this life has brought. Am I? It all depends on your point of view. Take yourself, for example. You've been told from the beginning of your adventure that you're the second coming of Nasruddin, the return of the living one. Do you believe it?
I wonder if I need to have Virgil with me to get the right dialogue tree for this.
Greetings. Long have I waited for your arrival, and finally this moment has come. I am Kerghan, first of the necromancers, voyager in the lands of the dead. I would think not. Although the presence of Aranax tells me you already know much of my tale, at least as much as he deemed necessary in order to bring you into his confidence. My life, yeah. This place, this void. Yes, I know. I truly wish I could. If only I could show you the places I've seen, you might understand the things I say. I've been to the desolate lands, wandered by those souls who still see the lands of the living, but wear the cloak of the dead. I see your soul, traveler. I can no longer tolerate the atrocity, and why not? I realize that you...
Are you daft, woman? Are you not listening to what this madman is proposing? He will kill every living being in both realms, including you. I think you have taken...
Splendid. I've spent the last 2,000 years developing my philosophy, but I'm always eager to hear another's thoughts. Please, proceed. Yes, let us speak of this. It is my opinion that the nature of life is accidental. That this reality we experience is merely a distortion of death. What say you, traveler? Yes. But what has that experience taught you? I know not the roads you've traveled, but I do know that all living things feel pain and loss. It's my opinion that they feel these things because they were never meant for what we know as life. Their souls are not equipped for it. Yes, you're correct. I concede you that point. But I have seen both sides, whereas you have only the lands of the living. Trust me when I say that the souls who are called back to this life are in the most excruciating pain. It's unnatural.
Yes, but perhaps that is the nature of those particular souls.
What do you mean? Are you faulting the souls of the dead for the meddlings of the living?
No, some souls are in pain because they hold on too tightly.
Well, you speak as if these souls have a choice when they're brought back. It's the mindless bravado of the living that subjects them to the vagaries of this life.
No, the pain is of their own making.
I'm willing to say you might be correct. But what proof have you?
What proof do I need? Your state is the only proof necessary.
That line of reasoning is weak and completely ineffectual. Perhaps our conversation is coming to an end.
I've spoken with souls who weren't in pain.
Just because some souls have accepted the nature of this distortion doesn't justify its existence. If what you're saying is correct, then what is the nature of death? Of life? Which is the natural state? Why is there pain on one side and uncertainty on the other?
The distortion is caused by the eyes with which we choose to see.
Perhaps it is my own arrogance, my own bravado that has brought us here to this crossroads. The question is, where do we go from here? We've spoken of fate, of prophecy. Have I traveled this road too long to turn back? Perhaps I have no choice but to continue on to the end.
No, I have a solution. I can free you once and for all.
Truly. I wish there were freedom for me, but I cannot let go of this life knowing that I might be called back to its pain. No, it seems I have no choice.
The Vendegroth device, it will sever you from this world forever.
Really? You can sever the bonds which hold my soul to the lands of the living? This object can actually do that?
Yes, I can free you from the pain that you fear.
So many years I've raged against the living. All those years, and the distortion was in my own soul. No man can see the nature of his flaws with diseased eyes. The contradiction lies within me.
Let me end your journey, Kerghan. Go to your rest.
Yes. I thank you, and I'm sorry. So very, very sorry. Perhaps some souls are born into death. They never knew how to live.
Yes, I think you might be right.
Goodbye, traveler. My road ends here. I wish you luck on yours.
Goodbye, Kerghan. And we made
because
it to the
end. Because delivered the secret ingredient to Jungle Dun, he perfected his alchemical process and eventually found a way to make gold from common lead. Needless to say, he became the richest man in all of our kingdom. The defeat of Lucan and his henchmen, coupled with your freeing of the ghost of Bessie Toon, enabled Shrouded Hills to grow and become a thriving community once again. A new silver vein is discovered in the old Bessie Toon mine.
Minus Rosette and a few others. Dozens.
And within a few years, Shrouded Hills is a bustling boom town. Such towns often have problems keeping the peace. Shrouded Hills has no such trouble, mainly due to the efforts of their new sheriff, Doc Roberts. Don Throg, because of the advice that you gave him, became a leading political activist in the fight for orcish rights. In time, he legalized orcish labor unions, secured the vote for all citizens, regardless of race or gender, and became the champion of equal rights and justice in Tarant. Before long, he was begrudgingly voted into the Industrial Council, and in a few years, he sat at its head. Cumbria, under the continued leadership of King Praetor, fell even further into decay. After his death, Dernon crumbled into obscurity, and Cumbria was eventually swallowed by the unified kingdom. Roger Thunderstone never returned to his people, and a distraught and confused Ranver assumed leadership over the Wheel Clan. Without a strong king, the Dwarven Clan splintered, and a bloody war followed. In time, Ranver gathered enough followers to put an end to the conflict, but the dwarves were never the same again, securing themselves forever from the outside world. Upon returning to Arcanum, Aranax buried his father on the Isle of Thanatos. Later he traveled to the Vendigroth Wastes, and there used his powers and single-handedly raised the city from the ruins it had become. Vendigroth again became a place of awe and wonder. Yet, after all of this, Arcanum is still what it always was. A place of possibility. A place of change. One thing is certain, and that is that nothing at all is ever certain in this place. Who's to say what the future holds for the land we call Arcanum?
And that's the game. It took a lot of deaths and three tries at the end, but we finally made it through this journey. A little bit of help from guides and a lot of trial and error. So go ahead and post this. Hopefully this is a guide of what not to do in a lot of cases. But the void, I found the best strategy is just it doesn't matter who, if you have followers or not. If you're not going to battle Kerghan, just speedrun the dungeon. I'd say probably speedrun the dungeon if you are. Speedrun the void as much as you can at least. Or a few fights you do have to get in. But hopefully you enjoyed this series. A long set of videos. Learned a lot in the process, so the next set should be of better quality. Please like, subscribe, and have a great day.